What if the most distant human-made object in the universe had been trying to tell us something, and we simply couldn't hear it? For over 4 decades, Voyager 1 has been humanity's ambassador to the cosmos. Launched in 1977, it has traveled farther than any spacecraft in history, now more than 15 billion miles from home, drifting through the void between stars. Its golden record carries the sound of Earth, music, laughter, greetings in 55 languages, a message in a bottle, cast into an ocean we barely understand. But what if Voyager wasn't just sending data back to us? What if, encoded in the hiss and static of its ancient transmissions, there was something else? A pattern. A structure. A message we lacked the tools to perceive. Until now. In early 2024, a prototype quantum processor, codenamed Majorana 1, was used to reanalyze decades of telemetry from Voyager 1 did. The chip, named after Italian physicist Ettore Majorana, operates on principles that blur the line between particle and wave, presence and absence. It doesn't just compute, it entangles with the data itself. And when researchers fed it the raw signal from Voyager's plasma wave instrument, something emerged, a sequence, a whisper from the edge of everything. This is the story of what they found. On September 5th, 1977, a Titan 30 rocket lifted off from Cape Canaveral, carrying a spacecraft no larger than a compact car. Its mission: explore Jupiter and Saturn, then continue outward forever. Voyager 1 carried instruments designed to measure magnetic fields, charged particles, cosmic rays, and radio waves. Its cameras captured the first detailed images of Jupiter's Great Red Spot and Saturn's rings. But perhaps its most poetic payload was the Golden Record, a time capsule of humanity, curated by a team led by Carl Sagan. By 1990, Voyager 1 had completed its planetary tour. It turned its camera backward and took one final photograph, the pale blue dot. Earth, a single pixel suspended in a sunbeam. Then, it kept going. For decades, engineers at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory have maintained contact with Voyager. The signal is faint, about 23 watts, the power of a refrigerator light bulb, and it takes over 22 hours to reach Earth. But it still transmits temperature readings, particle counts, the whispers of interstellar space. Most of this data has been archived, analyzed once, then filed away. Until someone thought to ask a different question. What if we'd been listening, but not hearing? Quantum computing is not like traditional computing. Where classical bits exist as either 0 or 1, quantum bits, qubits, exist in superposition. They can be both, neither, or something in between. This allows quantum processors to solve certain problems exponentially faster than any supercomputer. But there's a fragile, almost mystical quality to them. Qubits must be isolated from heat, vibration, even stray electromagnetic fields. The slightest disturbance collapses their state. They are as delicate as they are powerful. The Majorana 1 chip, developed by a coalition of researchers from MIT, Delft University of Technology, and Microsoft's Quantum Research Division, is different. It uses Majorana zero modes, quasi-particles that are their own antiparticles. In theory, they are more stable, more resistant to decoherence, and crucially, they excel at one thing: pattern recognition in chaotic systems. According to Dr. Yuki Tanaka, lead architect of the Majorana project, we built this processor to find structure in noise. Not random noise, but noise with memory. Systems where the past subtly influences the present in ways we can't classically detect. In late 2023, Dr. Tanaka's team was approached by a group of NASA data scientists with an unusual proposal. What if they ran Voyager 1's telemetry through Majorana 1, not the clean processed data, the raw signal, the stuff usually discarded as static? At first, the collaboration seemed academic, a proof of concept. But within 72 hours of processing, the quantum chip flagged something. An anomaly, a repeating structure buried in the plasma wave subsystem data, data collected between 2012 and 2023, the years Voyager 1 crossed into interstellar space. The pattern was invisible to classical analysis. It didn't repeat at regular intervals. It wasn't a malfunction. And it wasn't random. It was a sequence. Imagine trying to find a melody in the crash of ocean waves. That's what Majorana 1 did. The raw data from Voyager's plasma wave instrument is exactly what it sounds like. Measurements of charged particles buffeting the spacecraft as it sails through the interstellar medium. The numbers fluctuate constantly. Up, down, spiking, settling. To the human eye, it looks like chaos. But the quantum chip saw something else. When the data was analyzed, not as individual measurements, but as relationships, correlations across time, Nystad periodicities, phase-locked harmonics, a structure emerged. Dr. Elena Ruiz, a computational physicist at the Space Telescope Science Institute, who reviewed the findings, describes it this way. Imagine a song played backwards, slowed down, and split across multiple instruments. Each note is unrecognizable, but if you knew the algorithm, you could reconstruct the original. The sequence wasn't encoded in the data itself. It was encoded in the timing. The intervals between fluctuations. The quantum chip detected what classical computers couldn't, a non-linear pattern with fractal characteristics. When converted into a visual representation, it looked almost like a barcode. When converted into audio, it sounded like a heartbeat. A slow, steady pulse, rising and falling, almost deliberate. But here's where it gets strange. The pattern only appeared in data collected after Voyager 1 crossed the heliopause, the boundary where the sun's influence ends and true interstellar space begins. Before that moment, the signal was absent. It's as if something changed when Voyager left our solar cocoon, or as if something noticed. So what is it? The scientific community is divided, not into camps of belief and skepticism, but into flavors of uncertainty. The simplest explanation is that the pattern is a byproduct of the aging spacecraft. Voyager 1 is nearly 50 years old. Its systems are failing slowly. Perhaps the plasma wave instrument is producing harmonic noise as its circuits degrade, and the quantum processor is simply very good at finding patterns, even meaningless ones. This is the conservative view. But it has a problem. The pattern is too stable. If it were instrumental decay, we'd expect it to evolve over time, to drift, degrade, or change as components fail. Instead, the sequence has remained consistent across 11 years of data. Some researchers suggest the pattern reflects a natural resonance in the interstellar medium itself. Space is not empty. It's filled with plasma, magnetic fields, cosmic rays. Perhaps Voyager is detecting a standing wave, a cosmic echo caused by the interaction of particles and fields in a way we've never observed before. Dr. Marcus Liu, an astrophysicist at Caltech, notes, "Interstellar space is a laboratory we've barely entered. Voyager 1 is our only in-situ probe. If the plasma environment has structure we didn't predict, that alone would be a monumental discovery." But this, too, has a wrinkle. The pattern doesn't correlate with any known astrophysical phenomenon. It's not tied to the solar cycle, galactic rotation, or nearby stellar sources. It simply is. Then there's the third possibility. The one no one wants to say out loud, but everyone is thinking. What if the pattern is intentional? Not from Voyager, not from us, from out there. Let's be clear. There is no evidence, none, that the sequence is a message from an extraterrestrial intelligence. No scientist involved in the Majorana 1 analysis has made that claim publicly. But the question lingers, because the data invites it. If you were trying to communicate with a species that had just sent a probe beyond its star system, a species clearly curious, clearly technological, but still primitive by cosmic standards, how would you do it? You wouldn't send a radio signal to Earth. Too much noise, too many frequencies, too easy to miss. But a spacecraft already in interstellar space? A spacecraft transmitting data back to its creators? That's a perfect channel, a guaranteed listener. And if you wanted to be subtle, to test whether that species had developed quantum-level analysis, whether they were capable of recognizing non-linear information structures, you wouldn't make it obvious. You'd embed it. You'd wait for them to find it. Dr. Amara Okoye, a theoretical linguist and SETI advisor, offers a sobering perspective. If this were a message, it would be the most patient one imaginable. It's been repeating for over a decade. No urgency, no variation, just a signal, like a lighthouse or a test. Could it be a primer, a key to unlock something deeper in the data? Or is it simply proof of concept? Proof that we can see it, that we're ready. No one knows. Because here's the haunting part. We can't decode it. Not yet. The sequence is approximately 1,847 elements long. It doesn't repeat perfectly, but it cycles through variations, like a theme with mutations. Attempts to map it to known languages, mathematical constants, chemical structures, and genetic codes have failed. It doesn't match the Arecibo message, the Fibonacci sequence, or prime number patterns. It's not binary in any traditional sense. Dr. Tanaka's team has run the sequence through linguistic algorithms, cryptographic analysis, and even musical theory. Nothing fits cleanly. But there are hints. The sequence shows self-similarity at multiple scales, a hallmark of fractals. It also exhibits properties common in error-correcting codes, the kind used to protect data transmission from corruption. One researcher, speaking anonymously to Nature, said this, "It feels designed. Not designed for us, maybe, but designed." There's another possibility. Maybe we're asking the wrong question. Maybe it's not a message to decode. Maybe it's a test, a cosmic Turing test, embedded in the void, waiting for a species clever enough to notice. And now that we have, what happens next? There's something deeply human about this moment, something vulnerable. Voyager 1 is alone in a way nothing else has ever been. It will never return. In about 40,000 years, it will drift within 1.6 light years of a star called Gliese 445. By then, its systems will be long dead. Its golden record will be a relic, unplayed, perhaps unnoticed. But for now, it still speaks. Every day, its signal reaches Earth. And every day, someone listens. What if, in those years of silence, something listened back? Not with radio waves, not with light, but with something subtler, a modulation, a touch. The interstellar medium is not empty. It's alive with fields, particles, waves. If intelligence existed in forms we don't recognize, woven into plasma, into the quantum foam, into dimensions we can't perceive, would we even know? Voyager is our emissary, yes, but it's also our sensor, our eyes and ears in a place we cannot go. And now, through the lens of quantum computing, we're seeing those senses sharpen. We're hearing frequencies we couldn't hear before. And in that new hearing, there is a signal. Faint, strange, impossible to ignore. Whether the sequence is a message, a resonance, or an artifact, its discovery changes something fundamental. It proves that our tools are evolving. That quantum technology isn't just theoretical, it's useful. It can reveal hidden layers of reality that classical methods miss. It also proves that the universe still holds secrets in places we thought we'd already explored. Voyager 1's data has been public for decades. Thousands of scientists have analyzed it, and yet, until the right tool came along, this pattern was invisible. How much else have we missed? How many signals are already here, waiting in the archives, waiting for the next leap in technology to unveil them? Dr. Ruiz puts it this way, every time we invent a new way of looking, the universe shows us something new. The telescope, the radio dish, the space probe, and now quantum processors. Each one peels back another layer. This discovery, if that's even the right word, reminds us that exploration is not just about going farther. It's about seeing deeper. And as our tools sharpen, so does the question we've been asking since we first looked up at the stars. Are we alone? Maybe the answer isn't out there. Maybe it's already here, threaded through the data, waiting for us to notice. The Majorana 1 findings have not been officially published. They're currently under peer review, and NASA has not issued a formal statement. The work is being replicated by independent teams at CERN, the Perimeter Institute, and the Chinese Academy of Sciences. If the pattern holds, if others can confirm it, the next step will be clear. We need to go back. Not to Voyager. We can't. It's too far, too fragile, and moving too fast. but we can send new probes, equipped with quantum sensors, designed to listen in ways Voyager never could. We can also revisit the data from Voyager 2, New Horizons, and the Parker Solar Probe. Run it all through quantum analysis, see what else we've missed, and perhaps most importantly, we can prepare for the possibility that the universe is not silent, that intelligence, whatever form it takes, may not announce itself with fanfare. It may whisper, it may wait, it may test us, gently, to see if we're ready to hear. Voyager 1 is 15 billion miles away, moving at 38,000 miles per hour. It will outlast us, outlast our cities, our nations, perhaps even our species. But right now, in this fragile moment, it's still ours, and it's still speaking. What it's saying, we don't yet know. But for the first time in 46 years, we're hearing it differently, not as data, as signal, as possibility. The universe is full of patterns, most of them we'll never see, some we're not ready for. But this one found us. And now that we've seen it, everything feels a little less certain, a little more alive. If discoveries like this pull at something inside you, if the unknown feels like home, then subscribe, because the universe is just getting started, and so are we.